I'm gonna be taking care of you tonight. Actually, I'm not taking care of shit. I'm actually hosting this. I'm glad you're here. I'm gonna try not to yell like that. Alright, so where are the drunk people? Can I get a hand? Alright, drunk people, I need you to practice this right here. Not this, this is after the show. This part, right here. Now, if one of these sober motherfuckers decides they want to take out their phone and record shit or take a call or any of that other dumb shit, you just smack it. Right out of the hand. Second degree assault, you got my permission. I won't witness it, but I'll come to court for you. Sober people, anybody?
Yes.
Alright, we got one. I'm gonna love you tonight, thank you. Sober people, I want you to practice this, right here. He's the only one that gets to do it, watch out. Not this, this. This is for after the show. Yes, right here. That's right. Now, if one of these drunk motherfuckers decides that what they think is more important than this show, you just knock them right. Knock them right the fuck out. There it comes. We're the high people. Weed, pills, whatever. Like, yeah. All right. Hey. There we go. Yeah. All right, high people, you get to do whatever the fuck you want. I'm sorry. I'm sorry that shit is still illegal. You know, we're working on it. It's Maryland, it's time, you know. But I love you. You can do whatever you want, that's fine. Are there any Amish people here? Good, because I fucking hate Amish people so fucking bad. I really hate them. And I mean, look, I don't hate anybody for their color, creed, or religion, but fuck Amish people. Oh my God! I'm from St. Mary's County, right? So maybe you guys didn't have to deal with your means of transportation shitting all over the road on the way here, but I did. No, seriously though, like if I took my dog out to the park and he takes a shit, I gotta clean that up. Like, you can lay errant feces all over the fucking road and my fucking Crown Vic's gotta deal with it. By the way, Crown Vic, there she is over there. There's Miss Linda. Linda, right? I got it right, yeah. Well, I was trying to forget it. She showed up in a Crown Vic. I thought I was gonna get caught up on a warrant. I didn't even think I was gonna be here tonight. Shit's convincing. She's got the antenna and the little light and the whole fucking gambit. Right? Yeah. All right, so other than Amish people and Crown Vic, I do hate Amish people, seriously though. Like, everybody thinks, oh, Charlie, they're just poor people. Like, they're nice. Yeah, they're dirty as fuck. They fucking stink. Goddamn Amish people. With their stinking asses. I wasn't even gonna start there. I was gonna end there. I was gonna close this out with stinking and shit. But I'm just saying, look, if I wanna sell pies and jam and shit on the side of the road, I gotta deal with the food inspector and things like that. Fuck Jeremiah, that motherfucker can sell all the pies he wants to. Don't nobody charge him sales tax. And you know what? Fuck his roads. All over it. Shit all over the roads. They only put their kids in school when they inbreed them so bad that they fucking retarded, and then here you go. That's the goddamn Amish for you. Which brings me to my next point. Fuck Amish people. Fuck, yeah, can I get an amen on the fucking Amish tonight? I'm just telling you. They're just dirty motherfuckers. I don't like them. But anyhow. You got three good acts coming up tonight. They are from all over the place. One of them's from your hometown. And actually, he was one of the Amish people that went to school. He's kind of, I think some of you know. I won't say him by name, Cookie Monster. No, he's good people. You got all good people tonight. I love him, and I love all these people. But your next act, he's from St. Mary's County. He's seen the shit in the roads. He's seen the Amish people. I feel like Hitler up here right now. Like, fuck, he's Amish. The Amish are my Jews. I just want you to know that. If you're Jewish, I love you, but fuck the Amish. But anyhow, he's got all the funk, but he's all the frank. The next act up here, he's played everywhere. Down in St. Mary's County, probably never here, but I don't know what to tell you. He's a nice guy. And he does tell nice jokes. See, I'm still on my Amish rant. I can't even talk right now. I'm just like, man, I fucking hate those people. Anyhow, Just Frank's coming up. Give a round of applause. It's Just motherfucking Frank. Let's go. Amish step. I don't know what that is. Like, if it's like a clack, like you just come across the stage. But anyhow, I'm not just your host. I'm not just your host. I'm actually your orator of current events. That's part of what I do. I was reading, this is true, don't get your cell phones up, because then you're going to get hit in the face and all that shit I said earlier. So don't do that. But this is a true story. This is actually really fucking true. It's disappointingly true. So, in South Africa, which is known for next to nothing, South Africa, they just completed the first successful penis transplant. Yeah! Got two guys that want a penis transplant in here. Yeah. Elmo's one of them. That's three. Yeah. He said, I'm just done with this shit. Elmo's been doing good with that dick. I'm saying, y'all are here, aren't you? So, I mean, fuck. Must be doing something right. But anyhow, they completed the first penis transplant, successful penis transplant, which, I mean, first, if you're the Blade Runner, you're thinking to yourself, fuck, man, I got you guys gold medals with fucking no legs. You couldn't work on that, you're just giving white people dicks in Africa? Like, what are we doing right now? Everyone's like, look, I'm on the penis transplant list. Like, stop fucking making jokes about it. I understand. All right, no more dick jokes. She said, yes, I want a dick joke. No more dick jokes. All right, well, here's another one for you. This is another true story, you can look it up. About 6 months ago, down in Alabama, there was a field trip of mentally handicapped kids. I'm not fucking making this up, I promise you. Mentally handicapped kids, they're down in Alabama, they're taking a field trip, and they end up at a Bath and Body Works, no less. Which is like, begs the question, how the fuck do you end up at a Bath and Body Works on a fucking field trip? But, anyhow, Bath and Body Works says, nope, forget about it. Turns them away. Now, I'm a God-fearing man, I don't believe in it, but I still fear it. And I'm just saying, shit, you gonna turn away some handicapped people looking at some candles? Like, what is wrong with you? Maybe handicapped people just smell good. Maybe, you ever smell retard? I don't know, maybe they just smell good shit. I don't know, maybe that's their thing. So I'm saying, in this comedy thing, you have my promise, hand of fucking Jesus. If this comedy thing takes off, I'm going to open up a store down in Alabama. It's going to be called Recandle. Yeah. And we're going to sell nothing but flame retardant candles, because I understand the liability of it. I get it. But it's going to be handicapped people selling candles to handicapped people, because I think they need that. And I'm going to open that first store right down there in Alabama. And I know the first thing they're going to say, they're going to be like, what in retardation is this? People selling flame retardant candles at the Reed card. It's fucked up. I know. She's just thinking. She's like, I should have arrested him earlier when I pulled up. I thought you were going to fucking arrest me. I was like, damn, man. They caught me on driving on suspended for the fourth time, and I still got that fucking warrant. I'm in Charles County, and I don't know what y'all's lockup time is, but in St. Mary's, it's only 24 hours, so I can do that. But I can't be by myself for more than 24 hours. I just, boom. But anyhow, I'm a sports fan. Anybody a sports fan? At least I got a fucking hand for that. Woo! All right, so everybody hates Amish people. They're not retarded, and they're not from South Africa. Got it. Anyway, we got some sports fans in here. I'm a sports fan. I'm a Redskins fan. I'm a Native American. People make fun. Woo! I'm a Redskins fan. I'm an Indian. People look at me like, why aren't you offended that they call them the Redskins? I'm offended by their fucking win-loss ratio. I ain't fucking offended by the fucking name. If they changed the name to the Washington Redskins, I would quit watching football altogether. I'd go, fuck it. I'm done. If they had a team called the New Hampshire Niggers, I'd be the first one there rooting for them. I'd be down on the field like, come on, let's do it. Fuck it. Can you imagine that game, though? The Harvard Honkies versus the New Hampshire Niggers?
It's a matchup of epic proportions. We've got Sunday. It's the Harvard Honkies versus the New Hampshire Niggers.
Let's go down for some of that infield coverage. Hey, Steve.
Steve here. I'm down on the field with Tyrone.
Imagine if instead of making out with his boy, just soaking it up on live television, just
which is fine. Go ahead and make out with your boy, that's cool. Imagine if he just decked it. Boom! Fuck you! Right when he was signing that contract. What would they have said? Would they have gone, oh, we gotta suspend him for like 2 games. He's not gonna play for the Rams, he's gonna play for the Cowboys. And fuck that shit. AP can't play. Like, how the fuck is that? That's not domestic violence. I don't even know where that goes. I don't know where this goes. But I do know where your next part of this show is going to go. You guys, you don't have Cookie Monster. You don't have Big Bird. You got a motherfucker from your hometown. He's not Big Bird, he's not a fucking Cookie Monster, but he's motherfucking Elmo! Woo! Harry Potter! Alright, y'all are in love. I got a pitch, so this ain't gonna take too long. So. Anyhow, thank you, Elmo. Another round of fucking Elmo, right? So I'm gonna tell you two jokes, but like I said, I got pissed. Alright, so this is white guy, right? He's driving down the road, he's in the Dakotas. He's in between north and south, and he's driving down the road. He sees an Indian sitting on the side of the road. He's like, oh, that's a cool Indian. There's no trash. He's not crying. It's not a big deal. So he says, hey, I'm going to pull this guy, you know, pick him up. He picks up the Indian and drives him down the road. And the Indian looks up on the dashboard and he sees a brown paper bag. He's like, what's that? He's like, oh, I got a bottle of wine for my wife. And the Indian pauses for a moment and he says, good trade. Get it? Because I'm an alcoholic? Ah! Yeah. Alright, so when I'm not trying to make you laugh, I'm actually a waiter. And the cool thing about being a waiter is it's kind of like being a comedian, only people don't realize that you're actually dead serious. And so, you know, I finally get a chance to go take a piss. I'm not even going to tell you where I work, because I probably waited long, because I'm going to get it. Anyhow, I finally get a chance to take a piss, which I need to do right now, and I go to the bathroom and one of y'all come in and I'm thinking, fuck! Now I gotta wash my hands and shit. Like somebody's gonna see this. And then when I bring you water to your table, they're like, oh, thanks for bringing me water. I didn't even ask for it. I'm like, yeah, I even brought it in a clean glass. I'm like, ha 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 ha. I'm like, no, seriously, there's some dirty shit back there. Like, you should consider this later on. But my favorite thing is when I come up to your table and you got food, you got like one spring roll left, and I'm like, hey, do you want a box? You're like, no, I'm good. I'm fat and American. I'm happy. And I'm thinking to myself, wow, 40,000 people just died today because they didn't have enough food, but, you know, your glutton's ass can't take a spring roll home, but that's cool. Okay, so I tell you that to tell you this. I actually eat after people. Random motherfuckers, and I know what you're thinking. Oh, my God. I totally didn't like that guy after he said the fucking N-word. Now I definitely don't like him now. But anyhow, I eat after people. Now, I have a very specific reason why I will eat after you. It's very simple. If you're out with your family, your friends, and you said to me, hey, I got this van out back. You trying to fuck? If I would say yes, then I will eat after you. It's very simple. If you're down there getting it on, you finish up, she's moving over, and you see a fucking sandwich right there on the nightstand, and you wouldn't eat that sandwich, that's a nasty bitch you just fucking. That's what you look at. Now, I told that joke one time, and believe it or not, it actually bombed, and there was a woman breastfeeding in the crowd. And I said, I eat after that kid. Forgetting my own joke, I basically just insinuated that I'd fuck a baby, and I didn't mean that. What I meant was I'd suck that titty. But when I had to say that, I was like, shit, everybody just heard that. Everyone just heard that. Now, don't get me wrong. The menu says 10 and under. I say 10 and up. I've had some kids' chicken tenders in my time, like, as a waiter. Look, pepper is the best spice. I'm just saying, when I'm hungry, I'd fuck just about anybody. I don't know where else to go with that. I can tell you where I can go. I've been able to introduce every man tonight, both men. Hey, by the way, I put this tattoo on my fucking arm earlier because I was supposed to tell you there's no intermission.
Yeah, forgot that one.
But so there's no intermission. Yeah, I know, epic fail. Anyway, this next guy, he's funny as shit. He's a good guy. A lot of funny people are assholes, myself included. He is not one of them. He's a good dude. And I gotta read off this card for this motherfucker. I'm telling you, this is some accolades. This is what you paid for. Let's get a round of applause before I even talk about this motherfucker. How about that? I'm motherfucking Wayne. Your headliner has performed all over the United States, as he has, actually. From Maryland to California, the guy's been everywhere. He's been in England, he's been in the fucking Middle East. This guy's been everywhere. He's like a venereal disease, or like Elmo's dick, or that plastic dick that he brings to these fucking shows that he's not going over. He just finished up a TV show, Manor of Mayhem, and he just completed a TV on Comedy Central. TV special. This is bar none, good people. Put your fucking hands together for this motherfucker right here. His name is Brian Lee, and thank you guys for having us. Thank you for coming out. Get it together. By the way, Elmo said pussy earlier, which I find way more offensive than anything else I said. So I'm just saying, I don't like the P word. There's a couple girls right now that's like, I like that guy. I don't think I'm gonna get that. But yeah, put your hands together. Brian Lee, let's do it.